where he will specify his fees also. So I'll better show the progress that we are going to make. This is the home page of the doctor, and we will be completing the general bio where he will update his name, phone number and profile picture. As you are seeing here, this picture, name, phone, this will be completed. Then specialization will be added, whether he is a dermatologist, whether he is a cardiologist or whatever. Then fees also, this module will also be completed. So I'll start by opening the project itself so that we can start to understand. And before I proceed, I'll explain that this specialization will be a drop down, and it will need a list also. And fees is not a drop down, it is simply a text box, a pair of text boxes. General bio is again a pair of text boxes and a file upload for a small picture. We will start with the specialization model, because specialization is a list which will specify various specializations. And so let us start with our project. This is the project that you can see in the most simplified form. Areas folder, pages folder, shared folder. And now I'll click on the pages folder and to the models folder. Specialization I have added. If I double click it, this will give me the list of specializations. I have hard coded this specialization, but in another module I will show how to obtain the items of a drop down by reading a JSON file. And in fact, this could have been obtained by a database query also, but there are various ways. So this is one of the ways that I've demonstrated here. So have a look at, we have a public class specialization, specialization name, specialization code. Then we have a static function, list of specialization, get all specializations. So we have put this list into this function into the specialization class. This is also one of the ways of getting things done on a smaller scale. You put a static here. And get all specializations, all specs is new list, spec is allergist, specialization code. So this is a list that is returned. And then there is a helper function which are usually required. Get specialization from specialization code. So if some specialization code is applied, then get all specializations dot first or default C goes to C dot spec code and null, return empty. So this we'll discuss later because it's not required today right now. But we have added it because it may be helpful later on. So this first or default, I'm not sure whether I've taught it so far, but I'll explain. Get all specializations, first or default, first specialization or null, for which specialization code matches this parameter. If null, if nothing, no specialization is found, so spec code, this one, this spec code, if some spec code is not in the list, return empty. That is, there is no specialization. Otherwise, send the name of the specialization, pediatrician, neurologist, gynecologist, whatever. So after this, now let us move to our, I'll close the models folder. I'll close the pages folder. I'll come to the areas, come to doctor, because we are working on the profile of the doctor. As you can see here, this is the pages folder for the doctor. Index is the home page that we have worked in the previous tutorials. And fees is added, profile is added, and specialization is added. So these three we have added this time, and we will now work on them one by one. First of all, I'll open profile.cshtml. So this page is built on, this is the custom CSS, the header, the partial page for header to fill the header, and menu, and my profile. This will be sort of a heading H2. If model doctor dot profile picture is there, so I'll need to review with you what is this profile picture. So let us move to the model doctors pages models doctor profile. So this I should have actually taken reviewed first. This has an ID, name of the doctor, phone of the doctor, fees of the doctor, fees notes, clinic area, address will be done in later. Today these will be of use today. And if you remember, we are storing profile picture as a string, base64 string. So whatever profile picture will be uploaded by the user, it will be converted as a base64 string, because our string is going to be file is going to be small, so we can store it as a base64 string. Otherwise byte array would have been okay, but this is a bit easier to manipulate.